Resolution, and I think. And I saved up my wee money and I went to Woolworths at the bottom of Cabowie Road. Things like bank. My auntie Jean worked in the Woolworths there. She always looked after me, let me go crazy in the pick and mix. But anyway, I'd saved up my wee pocket money and what money I had and I went into Woolworths. It was 1973 and I purchased a record that changed my life right there and then. I didn't know what I was buying. I looked in. There used to be these little umbrellas and they'd put in cheaper records. You'd flick through, it'd be like Top of the Pops records, but it wasn't the artist that was doing the Top of the Pops record. They would have a scantily clad lady in the front cover. Not that that drew my attention to the Top of the Pops album, but the first record I ever bought was the Isley Brothers 3+3. It was an incredible record that was to change my life. Those two records were pivotal. And both of them were done in 1973, and it was the Isley Brothers 3+3 and the Inner Visions by Stevie Wonder. And both of those records were recorded at the exact same time in history in the same studio. Imagine that, those two records were unfolding. And what would we be involved in that project, just to open the door and hear those wonderful music. So when Pong Tin Sold Out was getting made, I kept on saying, can we do Don't Let Me Be Lonely Tonight? Can we do it, can we do it? I just love it, I love it. And I'm happy to say we did. And I'll be forever grateful for all the rest of the guys coming on board with us. So, Don't Let Me Be Lonely Tonight. Here we go.
Yeah.
say goodbye. Woman, say hello, hello, hello. Sure good enough to see you. Last song in Pop 10 sold out.
Oh, you sing it. Something so right, every night.